Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video we are going to talk about lighting. In real world, lighting is very easy. The sun goes up and everything gets lit, and if you want to light a room, you just press one or two light button and the whole room gets lit. But in 3D world, lighting is very complicated. For beginners, it is very difficult because you need to play with lot of lights to get the lighting correctly on your 3D model. So in this video, I am going to give a lighting preset in which you can just light your 3D model in just one click and it will look very cinematic. Okay, you will also get a dual color lighting in which you can make half side red and half side purple or whatever color you want to set up. Okay, so let's start the tutorial and enjoy our lighting process. And I have been wanting to make this video for very long time, but since I was not free, so I decided to make it today, guys, especially for you. So make sure to subscribe my channel and let's jump into Blender.
So friends, as you can see that we have opened Blender and imported Winter Soldier 3D model. Right now we are in viewport shading mode, that's why you can see everything shaded, but we need to light our model properly so that it looks cinematic. Okay, so first of all, you need to download the lighting preset which I have provided for free. You need to download this free light presets from Warlord tutorial, and you will find the download link in YouTube video description. So just download this file from there. Okay, then we will copy this file location, and to add this lighting in our scene, we just need to click on this file and then press append button. Then here paste your download location. For me, this is my download location, and you can see this is the file name that I provided you for free. Double click on this, and then you can see there is a collection folder. Again double click on this, and you can see there is 3-point sunlight preset which is available here. Just select it and press append button. Okay, you can see that the lighting has been imported. It looks very simple, but in reality this light will provide you a very cinematic look. So friends, after adding lighting, now we need to add camera so that we can preview our render properly. So to add camera, just press shift plus A on your keyboard, and here you can find a camera option. Just click here, press numpad 0 to go into camera view. You can see that right now we are in camera view. Now we will align our camera so that we can see the Winter Soldier properly. You can see now we can actually see the Winter Soldier properly, and this is how I want my render to look like. Okay, so before going into viewport shading mode, just go to this world settings and here turn down the strength. You can see by default it will be 1, but we need to change it to 0. Now we need to go to this render settings, and for now I am using Evee engine. I will show the preview with both Evee and Cycles engine. It depends on you what engine you want to use and render your scene. Okay, right now I'm on Evee engine and I have turned on the ray tracing. Okay, now we will go to the render preview. You can see this is the render preview and it looks very amazing. And there is also dual lighting setup here. You can see one is red and one is blue, and then there is front white light, and you can see how amazing this lighting looks. Okay, now I will show you the preview with Cycles engine. Okay, and you can see we can just change this to Cycle, and you can see this is the final preview of Cycles engine. Right now it's not denoised, there is a lot of noise here, but in the final render we can just denoise it by clicking on this denoise button. This is very GPU intensive process, so I am not using denoising right now. Okay, and you can see how much amazing this lighting looks in Cycles engine. Okay, now I will tell you how to tweak these lights according to your scene. So to control the lights here, you can just click on this 3-point light drop down folder. Just click here and you can see that there are 3 sunlights. We can basically change this intensity and rotation to actually change the light here. First of all, we will change the dual tone color here. So you can see this is the sun 02, this is basically the blue lighting, and if we go click on this bulb option or the light settings here, you can actually change the color. So right now it's blue, we can go to any other color. Let's go for something greenish maybe. And then for sun 01 light, it's in red color. We can change it to any other color. Let's go for yellow, or maybe something contradictory to green. We can use purple. You can see right now we are using combination of two other lights like green and purple. And we can also, if we want, we can keep this as white light, the main sunlight, or you can also increase the intensity to make it look brighter. And if you want, you can change the color of sunlight also to maybe a little bit yellow or any other color that depends upon your scene. For now, I will keep the default light to white because this is how I like my render. And you can see this looks very amazing. This is how easy it is to basically tweak this lighting. This lights does not depend on the position of the 3D model. Okay, it will light the scene no matter where your character goes in your scene. You can see once I click this render PU, you can see my Bucky is still lighting properly now. Even my lights are available here. It's not here. Still this Winter Soldier is getting properly lit, okay, and it doesn't matter where your Winter Soldier position is, okay. So this is one good thing about this lighting. And also we can change the color of this basically rotation of this lighting. Suppose we want purple light to appear first, or we want to somehow rotate this lighting. What we can do is just select all three of these lights from one Y holding shift, just click on sun and then shift select the sun 02. It will select all three of these lights. Now we can click on this rotate button and rotate the light. Let me show you what happens when you rotate these lightings. So you can see right now the purple is behind, and if you rotate it, you can see the purple is coming on front. And you can control a lot of things from here. You can either make like lighting, you can rotate according to yourself. And there are also many other different things like angle. You can just start playing with lighting and it will look more amazing. You can increase the intensity, decrease the intensity. You can play with angle, and there are many other things that you can use. But right now I will use this only, and this is basically my lighting preset. And this lighting depends on the rotation. Suppose if you want to change the position of the front light, you can only change the rotation and it will change the light that is on front facing side. Okay, you can see the light is changing when I change the rotation. The position of these lights does not matter. No matter where this light goes, the Winter Soldier will be properly lit. Okay, so this is the good thing about this lighting. So right now I will go for this position, and yeah, this looks perfect. Okay, and now friends, I am going to tell you how to add glow on these lights, because I want this part to be glowing, very glowy in nature. Okay, so for making glow in Blender, you can just go to this compositing tab, click on use nodes, and make sure in render settings your go to this performance and compositor, the device is GPU rather than CPU, otherwise your PC will crash. So for adding bloom, just add a node named glare and add it here, and instead of streaks, change it to I think bloom. Let's change it to bloom, and I will increase the size, and I think everything looks fine here. So let's go to the layout and turn this, click on this drop down and change it to always. You can see now the glow is added. Boom, you can see how much amazing this looks, guys. This light is perfect. And you can, suppose if you want to add glow in this green light also, we can increase the intensity so that the glow comes, and intensity, let's make it to 20, and then decrease the angle so that it become very sharp light. You can see now the green point is also glowing. You can see this is how this lighting works. Okay, and for rendering, you can go to this output settings and change this to 4K. You can see right now, and now we will render in 4K. So for rendering, just press F12, and if you want to render transparent, you can just click on this fill option and then press this transparent button. Okay, and then press F12, and you can see this will be rendered in no time with the glow. Okay, so yeah, this is how easy it is to use this lighting, and I hope guys you liked my tutorial. I was trying to make this from very start, but I was very busy. So yeah, this is one of the best lighting that I have given you. This is one of the simplest and very free preset and easy to use even for the beginners. This does not require any complicated setup or lighting knowledge. Just add your light. No matter where your model is in your 3D scene, it will get properly lit and will look very cinematic with just one click. Okay, so thank you guys for watching my video, and make sure to subscribe my channel and like my video, which motivates me to make more video. And I think we will soon get monetized. And so please give me support. Let's end this tutorial and see you later. And right now I think my render is finally completed. So this is how it looks like.